Hello. In this video you will listen me talking about the interview that Scott McQuate had on 25th of September 2013 on the Byte Show radio, and I will speak about that interview, and also I will speak about my opinions on Scott's claims and Scott's informations that he presented presented in that interview. Okay, so I will read my my text that I wrote about that interview, and I will and basically I will tell you the core information and most important claims and most important information that Scott McQuate presents in his Inner Circle site. Okay, and as a researcher. Okay, Scott McQuate is a Bible scholar and researcher of our reality. Maybe you already know that, but if you are not familiar with who Scott is and what is he teaching, then now it is a good time for you to hear information that I collected about his research and my personal also research. So now I will present everything what he spoke in his interview, in his radio interview, and basically I will speak about that particular interview. Okay, so Scott researched the Bible. He tried to find some hidden truth in language of Bible. Language of Bible is ancient language, Sumerian, Aramaic. Those two languages are important for him because he wants he claims that he found deeper meanings by looking at cuneiform language or form of Sumerian language. Okay, so, and Aramaic language. Okay, so that language is important in his research, but however I will now speak about this interview particularly. So I will tell you more about that. Okay, so the term end time is important to Scott. Okay, so Scott talked about the scribes, the liars who will try to deceive the people in the end times. Okay. So Scott believes that the end times are current times, 2015 and now currently is the period of end time, the period where we wait something to happen. Okay, here interesting to me is in Scott's research, it is interesting that Scott mentioned in this interview the law of entropy. Okay, that law says that everything in this world is in order and is constantly going into this order, into this order. So everything is going in nature, everything in nature is going to be dismantled and destroyed. Okay, the nature of material world is to be is to one day be destroyed. This world is created and is destructible. It have that nature that it will be destroyed eventually in future. Okay, but when exactly and what will happen really in future? Those are questions that are unanswered yet. But when we speak about the nature of our material world, the law of entropy seems that it is important because our world, our material things all have that characteristic that characteristic is that all things die when time passes away. As time passes away, all things or all material things, including human beings, tables, chairs, computers, etc., all is going to die. Everything is going to die. That is the nature of time. Okay. Scott, because of that, Scott supposes that our world will be destroyed. Okay. Will cease to exist. Okay. But when and how? It is a complicated story. But however, that law of entropy is interesting idea for me. Okay, Elohim actually is a word that describes and talks about the scribes, Pharisees, group of rulers, judges, and magistrates. Okay, that group of some beings. Okay, Elohim is a group of not human people, not people, not group of people. Elohim actually, according to Scott, is a group of beings. Okay, so maybe they are a group of some human beings, maybe they are a group of some spiritual beings, but however, according to Scott, when our reality was created, Elohim wanted to asked Elohim first asked the begged Elohim begged our creator or God to create a man or being on their image. Okay, so Elohim, I do not understand what Elohim exactly is, but according to Scott, Elohim is a group of spiritual beings. Okay, let's call that group angels. Okay, so let's say that angels are Elohim is a group of angels. Okay, so those angels, those Elohim group, that Elohim group asked God, asked for permission from God, so they can create a man, a human beings that will look like those angels, that would look like those group of spiritual beings. Okay, Elohim wanted to create human beings on their image. Okay, so that is basically the basic idea in Scott's research. Okay, very important idea, and that is something that is fascinating in Scott's research. And as I investigated on the internet about Scott, I found out that he is a real person, and it seems that he is not making some false claims. Okay, so I can say that I trust him. Okay, now it is November. I think it is 9th November 2015, and now I can say that I trust Scott McQuate. So I will continue to follow him and to follow his work and try to research his information and his data, so I can answer on some questions like when this world, this reality will stop to exist, and what will happen in future, what will happen with humanity, etc. Okay. Okay, so now I will continue with the story about the Elohim. And God said no to Elohim. Okay, God said no, you cannot make that human beings that you wanted to make. That you want to make, you cannot do that. Okay, but Elohim, heard that. Okay, and Elohim, that group, created human beings. Okay, they created human beings. Even God said no, but however, Elohim created human beings. Okay. Okay. Now I will continue. I am currently reading my text in my own language, and I am trying to tell you in English most important things that I wrote about this interview. Okay. Okay, so the Scott claims that he done the proper exegesis of the words of original Bible text. Okay, he claims that. Okay, I trust him that he really done that. Okay, so Scott claims that the man or human beings, when they were created, they were destroyed by fire because Elohim didn't liked the human beings that they created. Okay, so they didn't like the human beings that they created in first try. Okay, so Elohim created human beings many times. First they created human beings and they destroyed them. They destroyed the first humanity. Okay, the first humanity, I would say. Later then they created again human beings. They again created humanity and again they destroyed them. Because Elohim, it seems that Elohim wanted to find the best version of human beings. They wanted to create, they wanted to have as their ownership, as something they own, they wanted to have a best version of human beings. And maybe now it seems that we are the best version, I do not know what will Elohim do in the future, but however it seems that they want to make a perfect or the best version of human beings and to have them alive. Okay, because they already destroyed the human beings. They didn't like in the past. Okay. And about that destruction by fire, we can read in Genesis chapter 2, we can read about the destruction by fire. Okay. In Sumerian texts, it is said that Marduk created the man from blood of the son of God to work for EGG. Okay. And the Ijiji are the fallen Anunnaki beings or fallen angels. Okay, so in Sumerian texts we see that we have the figure called Marduk. Okay, and according to Scott, Marduk is actually a Satan. Okay. And the Ijiji, according to Scott, are the fallen Anunnaki beings or fallen angels. Okay. Also, here the important term in Scott's research is the term or name Lucifer. Lucifer. Okay. And Marduk, according to Scott, is a Lucifer. Lucifer. And it is important and interesting to notice that in Scott's research, in Scott's presentations, or according to his information, the Lucifer is actually a female being. Female being. Okay. Okay. Of course, the gold is always connected with the Anunnakis, According to Scott, the gold first created beings mined the gold, and that is important. But according to Scott, that gold have some esoteric meanings. So it seems that gold have some hidden meaning, not just some sort of physical economic meaning. According to Scott, the procreation or sex is something that is created, that is of course that act of procreation is created of course by Elohim and Lucifer. Lucifer is a female entity, and it is in the charge of those group of beings that created the human beings. Procreation is of course biological way of cloning. RNA is ribonucleic acid, is important to Scott, because Elohim created RNA, and they created it in some way, so we can be trapped or imprisoned in reality we are now currently. Now I read the text, so I'm a bit slow. So according to Scott, the rapture, the event of rapture, is a bad thing for us. It will happen in the future when this group of our creators, this group of spiritual beings who created us, will try to move some number of people from the earth into some other place. Into some other place. Also about the shape of the earth, Scott himself do not know how our reality looks like. He said once that Earth is maybe flat, but however, now currently 2015, we do not know how Earth looks like. Maybe it is concave, maybe it is flat, maybe it is some other type of design. But however, according to Scott, Elohim will try to implement the rapture event and to move some part of population, of human population, on some other place outside of this reality. Okay, and after that, the destruction of this world will happen. Okay, this world, according to Scott, will be destroyed, and it is a sure thing. It is 100% certain thing according to Scott. Okay. Okay. Elohim captured our soul. Okay. So, in essence, every human being is not a body. It is, in essence, a soul. Okay. And Elohim captured our soul in our body, and our body is put here in this reality. Okay. So we are, as soul beings, captured in our body and captured in this reality. It is important to know when you try to understand what Scott McQuate is talking about. Okay, we are the slaves in some way for Elohim. Okay, Scott thinks that we are slaves of those beings that created our body and our reality. Okay, in essence, we are souls, and we are soul beings, and because of that, we are connected to God. Okay, and Elohim is, of course, not God, not the same thing as God. Okay. Okay. The next thing interesting here is the meaning of Sera and Penta. Sera is the number 6, Penta is the number 5. And in general, genetics and biology and microbiology is the sciences that Elohim used to create and recreate human beings. Okay, and 6 and 5 numbers, in my opinion, are important because in our reality we can find that in geometry 6 and 5 relation is important. Okay, and I will maybe make a video about that. However, Elohim done some things to our molecules and modified our body, so we are now still alive in this world, according to Scott. Something was happening in the past when human beings were created. something was happening, that what is happening was the process of creation a human being. Okay, Elohim in first try they try to create a human being. It was not a perfect human being, so they destroyed them and again created some other type of human beings. Okay. We now, according to Scott, now currently we are living in the hell. We are living in hell as I speak, as you listen, because our world is hell, our body is hell. Okay, and that is basically that. Okay, that is basically that. Now I will tell you maybe a few more things. Okay, but I covered most of the topics. U.S. and Israel, of course, that theme is interesting. We know that Israel, in some hidden way, controls the United States. But about that, you should maybe watch the videos from Scott Onstott and Marty Leeds to understand how the English language is connected to Hebrew language, maybe, and to see how the numbers are connected to letters. Also check on my channel some videos, and if you are interested in that, let me know. I speak about the connection between the letters and the numbers, about astrology, about the Kabbalah, about how Freemasonry created the United States, and if you want to know more about that, I have the sources on that particular subject, and can share the sources with you. Okay, Scott said that Lucifer, that being, is a winged cherub, or cherub that covers. Okay. Okay. Bush said that U.S. and Israel are allies. They have some type of bond. Okay. Okay. Lucifer is the god of our world. I have many details about what Scott talked about in this interview, but most fascinating is, of course, that Lucifer is a female entity that created us. And weird thing here is that Scott said that Adam was a tree. was a tree in the Garden of Eden. So I do not understand that completely, but it is maybe some type of parable that Adam was a tree in the garden. Okay, also important thing to notice is that Elohim is actually can mean Allah, because the root of Allah is Al, and Al is the same as El. Also, according to Scott, the Virgin Mary is actually a Lucifer. Lucifer. Okay. And about the now, I can tell that when Scott speaks about the planet Saturn, it is an important word, and when he speaks about the planet Saturn, I compare that information with other sources, and I can say that that Saturn is definitely connected with the demons, and is definitely connected to the Freemasonry, and is connected to Jewish mysticism. Okay, because of other sources, I know that. So if Saturn is not a planet, okay, because we do not know if the Earth is convex, concave or flat or something else. However, the Saturn can be some place where genes or demons live. Okay, so if it is true, then I would ask what are they doing on Saturn, and what will happen in the future? Will they come to live here on Earth? Okay, and the problem I see one problem here in the planet of Tiamat. In Sumer texts, Elohim took the parts of planet Tiamat and created the Earth. Okay, so I would ask, is there really a planet Tiamat? Does it really existed? Did it really existed before? Okay, because currently I do not know, and I researched that. I do not know in what shape have Earth. Okay, and I do not know if the Earth have a core. Okay, but however, the ferrum or Fe chemical element is important also to Scott. Also, according to Scott, we as human beings are simply vampires and consumers. We are really parasites. We only eat and have intercourse or reproduce. We only do that in our life. We look really like some consumers. We always spend the energy on something. And Scott claims that the nature of Lucifer, the nature of Elohim, and the nature of our reality, and the nature of our body is that it needs that all this that they needs they need to consume things always and forever. The nature of material world is to consume, to spend, to die. That is the nature of our reality. Okay, and Scott said that we probably before we came into this reality, that we maybe were trees. That we maybe were trees, but trees in some other meaning, I guess, not in the meaning of this reality. Okay, before Elohim created us as human beings, according to Scott, we probably were trees. Or I would say we were souls and trees. Souls and trees. Okay. But I do not know, is that really true? Okay. Okay, okay. No. That would be all. I don't know what more to say. I have many things, many details written on paper, and I try to combine different researchers, to connect things between different researchers, in order to find a new information, to find a new truth, to discover the hidden information. Okay. So that would be everything that I wanted to say in this video. However, if you want to listen to radio interview US and Israel, watch it on my channel and write down all the details on that way you will if you are interested in this subject as I am, in that way you will find out more, and you will easily answer on your questions. Truth is not easily reachable. You must fight for truth, as Scott said. Truth costs money, Scott said. So I think it is true. And that would be all. Thank you for listening to me. I hope I helped you in some way if you are interested in these type of subjects. However, if you need more help to understand the Scott McQuate's theory, his informations and his theory about our reality, etc., write to me, and maybe and I will try to tell you from my perspective and from my experience. Maybe I can help you to understand these kind of subjects. Okay, so thank you for listening, thank you for watching this video, and bye bye, have a nice day.